protest program in Calcutta, protest program in Chennai, protest program in Kerala. Indian government under the leadership of Modi is trying to divert the attention. If you speak for minorities of India, I can understand, I agree, you are for minorities. But why you are speaking for the majority of Pakistan? It is directly after discussion, after getting voted, this has become the act. I am challenging Mr. Stalin, if you have guts, you go to each and every village of Tamil Nadu. This is not BJP today raising the issue. In one of the Prarthana Sabhas of Mahatma Gandhi, he has told, how can you say a party which has not fought independence? How can you say, sir? And then can you say that RJD has the history of independence movement? Can you say DMK has the history of the independence movement? And you are partnering and having the love duet with the DMK and say BJP is the only culprit? BJP government, which is known for taking decisions, which is not known for keep pending the issues. So Modi ji's government has taken the decision now. Tamilians is not a race which will be here because of DMK. What happened? What is happened? What happened? Any genocide happened in Sri Lanka in the last 5 years? I am questioning Mr. Stalin. You go and ask Tamilian leaders of Sri Lanka if they say that BJP is a factor for the genocide. I am ready to renounce politics. Are you ready now? Tell me. Agnikula Vamsha people from south, north, north, south, and Tamil Nadu south, Tamil Nadu north. How can you divide? DMK is fighting against the unity of the society. Congress and DMK are responsible for all this kind of pollution in this country. I am very happy and feel honored to be here, being invited by Chennai Citizen Forum to speak on a subject which is not just contemporary, but very seriously discussed all over the country. Not only seriously discussed within the country, various international organizations, countries, and diplomatic personnel are seriously looking into, and some of them are making observations, sometimes positive towards India, sometimes the observations are also against Indian government. So a very important subject which is affecting the Indian discourse. So on this, Chennai Citizen Forum has organized a timely program here in Chennai. I am thankful for the invitation they have given to me to come and speak on this subject. When we are sitting here, we are eminent people of Chennai here. Today there is another mobilization going on. And my brother Anna Stalin is there leading. And he says that Hindu Rashtra is coming. I am not aware where from Hindu Rashtra is coming. We thought it is already Rashtra we have. He is saying that somewhere from it will be coming. He is not allowed by the High Court of Madras to say so or to do so. And government is putting drones, what he is doing. Whether he is doing rightful thing or not rightful thing, and what kind of activities are going to happen. So now, here we are watched by media, they have cameras. But there, police commission and everybody is putting drones to watch what kind of activity they are going to do. BJP is surprised. and it is taking it as very unfortunate things are happening in the country. There is a protest program in Delhi, Srilampur, protest program in Calcutta, protest program in Chennai, protest program in Kerala. Why all these parties are organizing this kind of protest programs? And again they are saying that Indian government under the leadership of Modi is trying to divert the attention. If we want to divert the attention, why you want to get into the diversion? You can focus on economy, but you are not focusing. And you are focusing on citizenship rights for Pakistani Muslims. You are focusing on citizenship rights for Bangladeshi Muslims. There is no appreciation. You know, my sahodari Kanimodi has said that Hindu Rashtra. You know, where from she got, I don't know. Persecuted minorities. In the bill introduced as an amendment, Amit Shah has specifically mentioned 6 communities. And 6 communities in this, Hindus, 1 community. You have Parsis, you have Christians, you have Buddhists, you have Sikhs. Then if it is a Hindu Rashtra and if it is only allowing Hindus, why it should allow Christians? Why it should allow Parsis? Why it should allow Buddhists? This question is not answered. And these parties always speak about minorities. You know, for them minorities, Buddhists are not minorities. For them minority means Parsis are not minorities. Sikhs are not minorities. Only Muslims are minorities. I understand, if you speak for minorities of India, I can understand, I agree, you are for minorities. But why you are speaking for the majority of Pakistan? Why you are speaking for the majority of Bangladesh? So this is an important thing which we have to understand. Congress, communists, and in Tamil Nadu, DMK are aligned with the fundamentalist forces, have become an axis. And this axis is now orchestrating the violence all over the country. You see, wherever these leaders are, stones are being pelted. Wherever these programs are there, what is the purpose of stone pelting? What is the purpose of burning of the public transport vehicles? What is the purpose of burning the private vehicles? There is no statement from Congress leadership, highest leadership, that condemning this kind of violence so far. And Congress says, we have the monopoly of over Gandhiji. You all have listened to. Gandhiji should not be taken over by any other. And when we started celebrating 150th birthday of Gandhiji, they raised, where from Gandhiji? Chauri Chaura or other satyagrahas were organized by Gandhiji. Whenever there was a violence, he had withdrawn the satyagraha. He said, I will not lead the satyagraha because violence has taken place. When the satyagraha was not against the Indian government, the satyagraha, the protest was against the foreign government. When he was holding a protest against the foreign government, violence had taken place. Then he thought it is against my philosophy, my program, my method. Then he withdrew the protest movement. Now Congress party claims to be the great inheritor of Gandhian philosophy. And it says nobody should talk about Gandhiji other than Congress. In the last 10 days, you have seen all this arsoning is going on, firing is going on, stone pelting is going on. Now this party has not issued single statement condemning the violence. What right it has got? At least this is not a foreign government. Even you cannot say it is a foreign government. This government is elected by the majority of the people. It represents the majority in Lok Sabha. And this administration is now monitored by such a government. And at such a situation, these parties are not against violence and not against the arsoning. This shows the complicity of the Congress party and the communist parties and the fundamentalists. So we have to first understand the what is going on, what is the situation, what is the context. And this is not a great constitutional issue which people are not able to understand, and I need to speak for one and a half hour about this. This is a very small subject. And this issue has not come all of a sudden. It is not that BJP government has brought this issue immediately after coming into power without talking and without saying and without discussing with anybody. This was introduced in 2015. This was discussed in the parliament, Lok Sabha. And this was sent to joint committee of the parliament. And this bill was discussed thoroughly by the joint committee. And the report of the joint committee was tabled in the parliament. And it got lapsed because of the Rajya Sabha. Now after 2019, when Modiji's government, and this is mentioned in the manifesto of the BJP when we went for elections, and we discussed this issue before elections, during the election campaign. So now you, what is that you are asking? What is that you are saying that majority of Indians are not in favor of this? How do you know you hold the majority and BJP does not hold the majority? How come you have come to the conclusion that Stalin, Thiru Stalin has the majority to reject it, and Modiji does not have the majority to introduce and pass it? I am not. And what best institution you want in a democratic setup other than parliament to discuss about this policy issue? This policy issue, it was on live discussion. Everybody participated, all parties discussed. And after that there was a vote, and in the vote it got passed. And it is not just BJP which has passed. Number of parties have supported this bill, and then it became from CAB to CAA. This transformation of CAB to CAA is because of the parliament majority. It is not ordinance. It is not through ordinance. It is directly after discussion, after getting voted, this has become the act. If you challenge this act in the streets, then tomorrow, if you are in the government, how can you run the country? What is the moral authority with which you are questioning this? And you say it is unconstitutional. You know, we have a great hero in Tamil Nadu, leader of the Congress, and he says always what is constitutional and what is not constitutional, because he feels he is the only advocate who has the intelligence. You know him, Mr. Chidambaram. He feels in this entire country there is no other advocate most intelligent than him. And if you feel it is unconstitutional, then why you are unnecessarily doing all this hangama? You go to Supreme Court. And if you, Supreme Court says it is unconstitutional, then automatically it becomes unconstitutional. And Indian government cannot implement a law which is seen and judged by the Supreme Court as unconstitutional. If it violates the basic structure, if it violates the spirit of the Constitution, if it violates the spirit of the Constitution which you call secularism, if it violates the spirit of the Constitution which you call equality before law, then what best institution you have other than Supreme Court which will be judging? And it has seized the matter. But they are not. And they are not discussing about the CAA. You tell me where it is discussed. What is the provision you are discussing about CAA? All these parties are, what they are doing? You know, sometimes what happens, if you want to create a scene, for example, in the street you go, you just bend, immediately stop, get down from the car, and just bend and start seeing something on the road. Then somebody will ask what you are seeing. Then you say, I am seeing Rad Hanuman or something. Then that person also will start seeing. Then the other person will join. Then other person will join. Then the other person will say what you are seeing. No, what they are seeing, and then slowly you will have the people, 100, 200, 300. Then the traffic police person will come. He will also start looking in. What you are doing? You tell me, what is that you are discussing? What is that you are saying within this? In the CAA, there is nothing which is in CAA which is discussing about Indian citizens. Whether Hindus, Christians, Parsis, Buddhists, Sikhs, Muslims, anybody who are in this country, who are citizens of this country, they are not discussed in any manner in this CAA. They have the citizenship and that cannot be challenged and it need not be challenged and that is not questioned anywhere, and this subject CAA is nothing to do with Indian citizens. Why Tamil Nadu, you know, why these Muslims, I am not able to, why? For what they are coming? You ask them, are you interested in, you know, asking the citizenship for Pakistani Muslims? You tell me, in this entire country, you go and ask, are you ready to accept the Pakistani Muslims as citizens of this country? I am challenging Mr. Stalin, if you have guts, you go to each and every village of Tamil Nadu. I am ready to come with you to any village in Tamil Nadu. If any in Tamil Nadu village, any Tamilian, any person is wanting to have a Pakistani Muslim as a citizen of this country. What you are talking about? How can you equate Pakistani Muslim, Bangladeshi Muslim? And how can you say that we want them to become the citizens of this country? Well, they have voluntarily declared that we don't want to be part of India and we don't want to be the citizens of India. On the basis of religion, we want to become Pakistan and Pakistan citizens. And it was decided in 1947 and today's Bangladesh was part of that erstwhile Pakistan. It is settled. Today you cannot unsettle and start opening a new chapter. And Indians are not going to support it. So you have to understand the first important thing. Indian Muslims have nothing in stake in this CAA. It is not the Muslim issue which is discussed. Nor Indian Hindus, nor any other communities, any other religious communities
which are already having citizenship, their citizenship is discussed or questioned in CAA. And in this country, no government and no power has the design or capacity to question and this kind of citizenship issues. And Indian country is a country with all religions. All religions. And when the partition has taken place, you just see what was the number and percentage of the Muslims in this country? What was the total number? What was the percentage? You go and ask any person who has got the elementary knowledge that the population of minorities from partition, after partition, has increased in India. It is not reduced. We had a pact between Nehru and Liaquat. Because in the history of the world, this kind of partition has taken place. We do not have so many partitions affecting so huge population, and so many people were slaughtered and transferred, became refugees. This itself is a history, it's a great unfortunate chapter. In this, in 1950, there was a discussion that what about the minorities of each country? Pakistan was having minorities and India was also having minorities. What is the future and what is the security of minorities in each country? We have minorities in India and we have worshipping places of those minorities in India. In the same way, you in Pakistan also has got. Now you tell me, Liaquat Ali Pact and Nehru and Liaquat Ali Pact, which you call Delhi Pact. Today you go and evaluate whatever the commitments India has given in that pact are fully honored, fully committed, fully protected, fully safeguarded. And because of that, the number of Muslim worshipping places have not come down but has grown. The population of Muslims has not come down but has grown. The percentage of the Muslim population to the total population, it has not come down, it has grown. But what happened in Pakistan? In every aspect, the population of Hindus has come down. The number of temples which were there earlier in Pakistan today are razed, demolished, dismantled, you don't have. And the percentage of the Hindu population to the total population has come down. And this is not only the case of Hindus, even this is the case of all other non-Muslim minorities. So what is the sanctity of Liaquat Ali commitment in the pact? And in the last few decades, we have seen even what happened, the entire world has to accept what happened to after Taliban came into power in Afghanistan, in Bamiyan, what happened to Buddha statue, we have seen, the entire world has seen. Statues are not protected, historical places are not protected, and temples are not protected. And this has been the situation of Afghanistan and Pakistan, and in different intervals, the situation in Bangladesh also has been same. And in Bangladesh today, the same situation, the number of Hindus has come, they have come down. And the percentage of Hindus to the total population has come down. And these two countries and Afghanistan have been declared as Islamic countries. And these countries are governed by the Sharia. So now you tell me, why Muslims need protection in India? And I want to quote another thing. This is not BJP today raising the issue. In 1946, 47, when 48, when these things were happening, in one of the Prarthana Sabhas of Mahatma Gandhi, he has told, partition is not the mistake of the people who are living in Pakistan who are non-Muslims.
It is not the mistake, it is not the fallacy, it is not the failure of those people, nor it is the failure of the people who fought for the independence of India. When people were fighting in Lahore, in Karachi, in Sindh, in Hyderabad of Sindh, they were fighting thinking that it will be united India. Bhagat Singh, Lala Lajpat Rai, Bhai Paramanand, when all these people were sacrificing, they never thought this will be partitioned. It is Nehru, it is Congress which has failed the country, and partition has become reality because of the Congress agreement to the partition. Mr. Chidambaram, if you have a historic sense and guts, come and tell. Can you disagree? Can you refuse that partition has taken place because of the final agreement of the Congress leadership with the British government? Religion has become the basis of the partition, not just because of Jinnah. Jinnah has fought, Jinnah declared, but you have agreed, you have submitted, you have surrendered. How can you today say BJP is responsible for the partition? You cannot speak both the things. You say BJP has nothing in its history because it did not fight for independence. What is the problem, sir? My date of birth is 1964. How can you say that Muralidhar Rao has not fought for independence? How can you say? BJP has come into existence in 1980. And Bharatiya Jansang, the previous avatar of BJP, it came into existence in 1950. How can you say a party which has not fought independence? How can you say, sir? And then can you say that RJD has the history of independence movement? Can you say DMK has the history of the independence movement? And you are partnering and having the love duet with the DMK and say BJP is the only culprit? Where is the logic? So you are claiming that you have brought the independence, but you are refusing that partition is because of BJP. This is senseless logic. It will not stand. So when you said it is partition has taken place because of the religion and because of the surrender of Congress leadership, you know, 50% love can never happen. You know, one boy, he was my friend. He told me, you know, I have a love affair with a girl. Then I asked, how far you have come? No, it is almost over. I asked, just tell me what is the, how far you have come? No, 50% is over. I asked, what does it mean by 50%? Then he said, from my side it is over. Sir, from your side if it is over, girl is at zero, how can you have, you know, it is over? You know, Jinnah has waged the war against the country and partition has happened. It cannot happen. It could not have happened. Without Congress acceptance and surrender, partition could not have taken place. It is a failure of the Congress. Now, when Congress has failed, Gandhiji has realized, he told, it is because of my failure, our failure, party's failure, then, and the other Pakistan is getting created on the basis of Islam, then the non-Muslims in Pakistan, whenever they feel, this is not safe, this is not my home, I am not comfortable, I am not insecure, then whenever they feel, not now, any point of time, they can come and settle and they can take India as their home. We are ready. This is the solemn commitment he has given to the entire world, to the people, minorities of the Pakistan.
Entire world was witness. Now you say they should not be taken. How can you say so? This is a historic responsibility and constitutional obligation we have. And it is a pending demand. You see the video viral which has come. There was a debate within the parliament when Advaniji was Deputy Prime Minister. Manmohan Singh has spoken on this issue. He has spoken on the issue saying that these minorities, persecuted minorities, they don't have anything to go. They should not be treated as refugees. They should not be treated as stateless and homeless persons. And they have lot of problems, employment problem, property problem, security problem, dignity problem, identity problem. Who else can understand more than Manmohan Singh? Because he knows the trauma of the partition. It is on record. So don't classify it as only a BJP's Hindu Rashtra internal some conspiracy and we are working outside. So we have to understand, these are the historic things. And the people who came at different intervals, they are having problems. In Bengal they have problem, in Assam they have problem, in Delhi they have problem, in Rajasthan they have problem, in Gujarat they have problem. And the administration is harassing them. Ultimately, administration, they think about how to harass, because when the law, legal framework is not there, they become subjects of the mercy of the administration. So a legal framework was required, and it was overdue, and it was pending. So keeping that in view, BJP government, which is known for taking decisions, which is not known for keep pending the issues. So Modi ji's government has taken the decision now. Now issues are, if the CAA is implemented, now there is a problem in Northeast. Indian Home Minister Amit Shah had meetings with the Northeast people, Mizoram, Meghalaya, Manipur, Arunachal, Sikkim, Nagaland, Assam, and the government tried to understand and tried to convince. When they said there will be a problem of demographic change, no new Bangladeshi, whether Hindu or Muslim, is going to come and settle after 2014. And there is a cutoff date 1971. And after that, the Barak Valley, Brahmaputra Valley, there are two valleys in the Barak. The Bangladeshi Hindus are settled. They are settled, they are having, they are living, and they are part. Now no new Hindu will come. This has been assured. And it will not be the only responsibility of Assam. And two safeguards have been clearly given in that, Manipur also included. Inner line permit, ILP. Nobody can visit these states, certain designated areas of these states, without inner line permit. And sixth schedule of the constitution, tribal lands will be fully protected. Tribal culture, tribal identity, and tribal lands will be fully protected, and nobody will be allowed to settle in those areas. Issues are addressed. Now Assamese government is also thinking about coming out with the, Assam Accord has been signed. It is not implemented. It's signed by the Congress government, but never implemented. And there is a sixth schedule, the sixth Article 6 in the Assam Accord. In that it is mentioned that Assam government is entitled to take any initiative to protect the Assami language, to protect the Assami identity, and to protect the Assami livelihood. And in this, central government has granted, and state government is now fully aware, and they are going to take action to implement the Article 6 of the Assam Accord. After Assam Accord is signed, Congress government was there, but they have not implemented. And you now raise the issue of insecurity. Where is the issue of insecurity? And Modi ji's government has clearly said, we are not intending to change the character of the identity of the Northeast, whether it is Assam or other remaining seven states. BJP respects their identity. If there are Bangladeshi Hindus, it is not that they will only settle in that area. They can settle in any place. So this is important. All misinformation, anxieties, you know, to generate anxiety, to generate insecurity, and to create a flame, wildfire, these parties are indulging in for the last 10 days. Now, what somebody says, you are not talking about Tamilians. Sir, I want to say, before take up Tamil, I want to say another thing. You know, Amit Shah in the parliament, he has clearly said, Muslims, even after this amendment, can continue to come from Pakistan, Bangladesh, Afghanistan, or even from other countries, because we have a Citizenship Act of 1955. With this amendment, the Basic Citizenship Act is not getting changed. We have created a special window to address this special issue. We have not changed the entire Citizenship Act. If anybody wants to become Indian from Pakistan, even Muslim, even after this amendment, Muslims are not prohibited. They can come. There is a general gate, general entry. There is no special entry. Through that general entry, naturalization process, you can come, you can apply, and when satisfied, you can, like that, 500 Muslims have been given. In the last 5 years also, many people have got this. So you have to understand, Citizenship Act is not changed. There is only a special window for a particular non-Muslims, persecuted minorities. This is a special case. Now, special case, now our DMK leaders and Congress leaders from Tamil Nadu, they say, BJP is against Tamilians. The sole property of DMK, Tamilians. When they came to this earth, they have come with Tamilians, and when Tamilians are, when they do not there, if DMK tomorrow it is not there, then Tamilians will not be there. Before you, Tamilians were there. And after you also, Tamilians will be there. Tamilians is not a race which will be here because of DMK. And we know the commitment of DMK for Tamil and Tamil people. I am asking a straight question, sir. When did this genocide happen for against Tamilians in Sri Lanka? Was BJP in power in Delhi at that time? You have, you know, both Congress and DMK, both are responsible for the genocide for Tamilians. And they have been running the government here, and they have been running the government in Delhi. And they talk that BJP is anti-Tamil. In the history of Tamilians, if there is a genocide happened, it happened only during the regimes of DMK and Congress in India. When Modi ji is there, dare not. What happened? What is happened? What happened? Any genocide happened in Sri Lanka in the last 5 years? I am questioning Mr. My Anna Stalin, you go and ask Tamilian leaders of Sri Lanka, if they say that BJP is the factor for the genocide, I am ready to renounce politics. Are you ready now? Tell me. And Rajapakse got elected, and the very first day after taking this oath, he came to India and he met Narendra Modi. And Modi ji said in uncertain terms, for me, Tamilian security is paramount. There is a problem. human rights problem. And we are fighting to defend the human rights problem of the Tamilians in Sri Lanka. BJP's commitment cannot be questioned and cannot be doubted. And we have always fought for their rights. And Modi ji went and specifically went to northeastern part, and he went to inaugurate the housing project and housing completion in the highland Tamilians. What you have done? And for me, Tamil language, I am not able to understand. Sir, yesterday I came here, I saw a paper, newspaper. In this newspaper, there is some Anna's literature is launched. On the occasion of that, Thiru Stalin has issued a statement, we are not going to fight only against Hindi, we will fight against even Sanskrit. I have a problem. He is insulting BJP or he is insulting Mr. Vishwanathan? You have to change your name to Stalin. You have the Vishwanathan. Vishwanathan name is a North Indian or South Indian? No, Stalin has a problem. I will give 30 days to him. You solve this problem. Vishwanathan is name North Indian or South Indian? I am asking you a question, sir. Can you solve this problem, Vishwanathan, whether it is a South Indian or North Indian? He is a South Indian. I am talking about Vishwanathan name is North Indian or South Indian? And Lord Shiva is a South Indian or North Indian? And Lord Shiva's family is South Indian or North Indian? If his abode is Kailasham, it is North India. If his abode is Rameshwaram, it is South India. Now you have the problem. Sir, I am asking, don't fight against Lord Shiva. Don't try to create division with Lord Shiva, South India, North India, South India, North India. You will go, Lord Shiva will be here. I challenge Thiru Stalin, come to every village and say, then every villager will talk about, no, we are connected, we are not separated, we cannot be separated. How can you separate? I was reading, sir, you belong to 1 year. You are proud of your 1 year clan history. I was reading 1 year's history long time back. You come from Agni Kula Vamsha. Agni Kula Vamsha. I want to know, is it belongs only to Tamil Nadu? Where from it has come, sir? Agni Kula has come from Agni. And these people are not just here, they are in Andhra, Telangana, everywhere. Agni Kula people are everywhere. How can you divide Agni Kula Vamsha people from South, North, North, South, and Tamil Nadu South, Tamil Nadu North? How can you divide? DMK is fighting against the unity of the society. Not only that, sir. I was working in Tamil Nadu for so many years. I've been. Devendras are there. They feel we are descendants of Devendra. Here also there may be few Devendras. What are the Devendras? Say now, Devendra is a South Indian or North Indian? Indra is a South Indian or North Indian? Then this community will answer you, what is it? Sir, don't get into this, then DMK will get washed away. BJP is ready to fight you. If you fight against the culture, then you cannot fight and you cannot create division. Don't get into the false logics. Now, Tamil people, I have answered. No, Tamil people, why you have not included Tamilians in the bill? So when Tamilians were included, why these people were not included? I ask another question. In 1964, when Tamilian issue was partly resolved, Sirimavo Shastri Pact, He came here for 6 days. There was a negotiation. After 6 days of negotiation, you have the pact, Sirimavo and Shastri pact. And according to that pact, the Sri Lankan Tamilians, at that time 9,25,000, in that 5 lakhs were taken to India, and before that they were stateless people, they were citizens, they were not citizens of any country. They migrated to create the sound economy in Sri Lanka during the British time, but they became stateless, and when they became stateless, this pact has absorbed 5 lakhs into India and 3 lakhs have been granted citizenship by the Sri Lanka. After that, in 1986, you have amended, and Indira Gandhi amended, and in 98 again amendment has taken place. So, if I ask, why Hindus of Pakistan were not incorporated in that, can you answer this question? Is it not a mindless question? So, yes, specific, when people from Uganda came and they were given the citizenship, then these people were not included. So in the history, in the dynamic history, at different points, we have addressed the problems in a different ways. So we have addressed the Tamilian issue. We have addressed the Uganda issue. Now we are addressing a long pending issue. So don't club this issue. Tamilians are very important. BJP's commitment to the Tamil cause is non-negotiable. And BJP, in its nationalism, you know, don't think that Tamilians are not there. Tamil language is very important. That was the reason when Atalji went to United Nations, he spoke in, you know, he quoted Tamil. When Narendra Modi ji, not only when he came, even when he went to United Nations, there were no votes. There were no elections. And Modi quoted Thiruvalluvar, Modi quoted Tamil. In my nationalism, in my definition of nationalism, Tamil is very important and valuable part of our nationalism, and BJP's commitment. How can we say we are working the glorious part of the India, glorious India? Rajaraja Chola, Rajendra Chola, who can we forget, who created a global empire and expanded the Indian influence till Cambodia? The naval power, Indian Sea. These were the emperors who created the influence. So don't insult Tamil Nadu by making this kind of comments. Narendra Modi ji and BJP's commitment for not only Tamil cause, but the total national identity. And these people say, you know, Congress has come with this, you know, otherwise there would not have been a secularism. In my Hindu thought, in my Indian thought, in every village, we have been taught that every path is equally true. Is it a Congress-given statement, sir? Sarva Panta Samabhava, or all paths, all religions are equal. You go to any Christian country, you go to any Islamic country, you have even today. A few days back, I went to South Korea. There I told, every religion is equal. Then they questioned, how every religion can be equal, sir? For them it is not understandable. They don't accept every religion can never be equal. And they don't say that even constitutionally every religion is equal. Even the secular countries don't say. But in India, we say every religion is equally true. This is the contribution of India. And that is the reason we do not have uniformity. That is the reason we have the diversity. And the diversity, we take it as greatest attribute of Indian nationalism. And BJP, it's an ideological commitment for this nationalism, this definition of nationalism. And we don't have any conflict with Indian constitution minded. We are celebrating the Indian constitution every day, and we are upholding the Indian constitution every year. And in the parliament and outside, when we work for the democracy and democratic strengthening, we are upholding the Indian constitutional values. So don't think that BJP has a conflicting interest with the constitution. We don't have any conflict with the constitution. You say something in one day and you say some other thing another day. You don't respect the constitution. You created the vote bank politics. You created the perversion. You created the distortion. You created the subversion. Congress and DMK are responsible for all this kind of pollution in this country. Everybody is saying Delhi is polluted. Chennai is polluted. For pollution, again I am telling you, my date of birth is 2014. How can you call we have polluted? If pollution is there, it is because of you. We are only correcting. We are only changing. We are only amending. So, dear friends, in this CAA, and now they talk about NRC. And one gentleman was asked, have you read the NRC? He said, no, I have read completely line by line. What is that NRC? NRC has not come into existence. There is one NRC in Assam. And that NRC of Assam is not created by BJP. That NRC has come into existence during the Congress time and it got completely implemented under the monitoring of Supreme Court. BJP as a political party has not started NRC. And nationwide NRC. Now you tell me, where is the nationwide NRC we started? And everybody is saying, we will not implement CAA. Who are you to implement? Citizenship Act is nothing to do with the state government. State government can give permission to do dharna or not to do dharna. You cannot give the citizenship. Thiru Stalin first or Chidambaram, they should first read the constitution carefully. They should not say, don't get into the orchestrated misinformation campaign. CAA does not depend on your implementation. And NRC implementation, you are saying we will stop, we will not. What is the false hero? You know, in Mahabharata, there is a story of Uttara. Uttara was taking, within 1 minute, I can finish this. Within 2 days, I can finish this. And he was talking. When he started facing the Kauravas, he was not having any stamina, strength. So this is what we call Uttara Pragalbha. What do you call in Tamil Pragalbha? Uttara Pragalbha. Pragalbha means, you know, you say great things. I will do this without this. What do you call in Tamil? No, challenge not. It is not challenge. It is only talking big things. Valchivada. So now these people are doing that. Sir, I will not implement NRC. Where is NRC? You know, before NRC is formulated, there will be discussion, there will be, when NRC is found in Assam, there is no discussion in the cabinet. There was no Congress government has discussed. No Congress government has passed. No Congress government has discussed in the parliament. Now we are only talking about NRC. Still, till date, NRC is not there. And without discussion, without consultation, without taking the confidence of, stakeholders, where is that? BJP is a democratic party. So don't talk about the things which have not come and don't unnecessarily create link between NRC and CAA which is not there. So BJP is opposed to misinformation campaign, mischievous campaign. BJP is opposed to tarnishing the image of the country at the global level. Now, Organization of Islamic Countries has taken note of CAA. I am asking, what is this OIC? No, don't take Organization of Islamic Countries all put together more than India. It is not that, Kerala is bigger than OIC. What you are talking about? You don't have a right to talk about CAA. I am not talking about the domestic laws of Saudi Arabia. I am not talking about the domestic laws of Kuwait. I am not talking the domestic laws of Turkey. I am not talking the domestic laws of Iraq, Iran. What guts you have got to discuss about the domestic issues of India by OIC? When temples are demolished in Pakistan, where were you? When people were killed in Pakistan, where were you? When women were raped in Bangladesh, where were you? When what OAC was doing? When they were coming as a wave after wave as refugees to this country, what this OAC was doing? Not a single resolution passed by OAC for the purpose of defense of non-Muslim minorities persecuted in these countries. BJP knows how to handle the situation. Our patriotism is not suspected. Our commitment to national dignity and national security is not doubtful. Our politics are not meant to have a negotiation with the national interest just to retain the power. We don't have that history. We don't belong to that family. And the social justice and equality and human rights don't teach us. Family rule and social justice, they talk and they go together. I am not able to understand. Narendra Modi ji could become Prime Minister of this country because of the BJP's commitment and India's commitment for the social justice. Without this commitment, he could not have become Prime Minister. So we know all these things. So my appeal to all of you is, please take the responsibility of educating each one, teach 10. Educate 100. Meet 1,000. Consult 10,000 people. Please do this. You have a mobile now. Do some SMS. Send some video. Educating, informing, and challenging, taking the questions. So my appeal to all educated Indians to take care of this, and in coming days, we will change the face of Tamil Nadu too. I am very happy for the organizers giving me an opportunity. Thank you.